My name is Kyle Burrows, and I am a graduate student in Colby Zaff's lab at the Biomedical Research Center. The thing I enjoy most about research is the challenge. So there's no easy way to do research. It takes a lot of hard work and a lot of commitment. When you do have a breakthrough, when you make a new discovery, and it's a great feeling to have. So my research project is focused on mucosal immune regulation. So I'm interested in the factors that regulate immune cells at barrier surfaces, such as the gut or lungs. These cells are quite interesting because they have to both rapidly respond to incoming pathogens, such as virus, bacteria, or helminths, but also they have to tolerate commensal bacteria in the gut, as well as innocuous food antigens. And what we found was a novel transcription factor that we believe is only expressed in T cells located in the small intestine. So interestingly, when we knock this molecule out or inhibit it in T cells, we find that cytokine production is altered. And in doing so, we were able to prevent disease progression in different animal models of colitis. So we find that it really has an effect on Th17 cells. This transcription factor seems to, when we inhibit it, it seems to allow T cells to produce a lot more IL-17 and a lot more IL-10. So it seems to promote barrier function and immunoregulatory molecules. So we think that's how it's protecting from disease progression in colitis. So I think a very hot topic right now with mucosal immune regulation is innate lymphoid cells. So they were discovered not too long ago, about 5 years, and research with them has just exploded. So they were originally discovered as a single subset, but now there's multiple subsets, ILC1s, 2s, and 3s. They have very different functions. ILC2 in the lungs are very important for inducing airway inflammation in response to antigens. You have ILC3s that are important for microbial defenses, as well as regulating responses against commensal bacteria. So I think there's a lot of research focusing on the ILCs right now, and it's only going to expand in the future. I've been using EasySep pretty much since the beginning of my grad school career. It's probably been about 4 years now. Primarily, we use EasySep for CD4 T cells. I have used it for CD8 T cells in the past as well. I think EasySep helps my research because it is very quick and easy, so it's a great way to isolate cells fast in order to get a pure population that has great viability. You don't have to worry about any cells lost.